Hello and welcome to Out and About. I'm Diane Gonzalez. A new musical is coming to the Lead Center to tell an important story about childhood hunger right here in Lincoln. Puddin' and the Grumble is part of the Grumble Project, a collaboration among the Lead Center, the Lincoln Community Foundation, and the Food Bank of Lincoln. And joining me to discuss this important community-wide initiative are Bill Steffen, he's the Executive Director of the Lead Center, Barbara Bartle is the Executive Director of the Lincoln Community Foundation, and Dwayne Taylor is one of the stars of Puddin' and the Grumble. Thank you all very much for being with us today. And Barbara, I'm going to start with you because this really all came out of the Vital Signs Project, which is an effort of the Community Foundation. Tell us about that.
Well, it's actually an effort of 13 funders in the community. We were concerned in about 2011 about the budget cuts, federal, state, and local, and the increased needs in our community during that time. And so we worked with the University of Nebraska Public Policy Center, and they helped design for the community Lincoln Vital Signs. And it's a report of all the information we have in the community, around seven different indicators. And then they analyzed it, and we learned that the findings are three things. One, we're doing extraordinary things in the community, as we all know and we can see, and we're so proud of our schools and safety and the unemployment levels. But at the same time, we've had an increase of poverty of 48% since 2008, and especially vulnerable are the children. Since 2005, we've doubled the number of children in poverty. And so we, on January, the end of January of 2014, we launched Lincoln Vital Signs, had over 500 individuals, probably 800, at a community breakfast, and reported on vital signs. And fortunately for all of us at this table, we had the Lead Center for Performing Arts in the room. And they heard those statistics, and they walked away, and they said, we want to help do something about that.
And Bill, take up the story from there.
Sure. Well, we were, you know, certainly concerned with some of the findings related to the hunger issues in Lincoln, and as an arts organization, how can we play a role? Normally, you think of performing arts as entertainment, but also the arts can really convey important messages regarding life and life issues. And so we brainstormed together and came up with the concept of let's create a musical that tells the story of hunger and hope and family and friends and how to make a difference and create awareness about the issue in the community. And we're just so thrilled to be able to play a role in this vital issue in the community.
So the Lead Center commissioned a musical.
Right, it's we not only commissioned, I mean, we're really creating it. Becky Boson and David Von Kampen are, you know, created the musical, but we produced it all the way from the very beginning. We've commissioned other things in the past, but we were having rehearsals, the set's being built at the Lead Center, it's from the ground up. And so it's an exciting creation of art that's quite unique.
And it's being funded by the Community Foundation as a very special gift.
It is. This we were in our 60th year at the Lincoln Community Foundation, and we had requests for proposals out in the community about ways that we could celebrate and make gifts to the community. And the Lead Center came over with this wonderful idea, and we were really thrilled to be able to make a major $60,000 grant to be the presenters of Puddin'. We're very proud to be a part of this.
Okay. Dwayne, tell us about the musical itself. Tell us the story and also what role you play in Puddin' and the Grumble.
Yeah, the story basically follows a very young girl. As you find out about her, you find out that she's hungry. And there's a lot of layers to hunger. And this show really explores the different layers there are to hunger and how it really affects children, but how it also affects the family dynamic and how that family dynamic then affects the community dynamic and how all of those things may rely on each other and how each of those parts individually helps sustain the whole system itself. Now, where I come in is I'm one of Puddin's friends. I kind of am there to help her out when she needs it, but I'm also the sound of the show. So what I provide is sound effects. I beatbox, and if you don't know what beatboxing is, it's where you use your mouth, nasal passages, anything in this area, really to create sounds. So some of the grumble sounds, and that's Puddin's hunger is the grumble. Some of those sounds may be, or just very sounds that kind of embody the hunger, but also show that something's happening. There's something deeper going on, and it's the audience's job to figure out. I also have a little bit of a surprise for those that do come see the show about what my character does and how my character develops throughout the show.
And we should mention, Duane, you're a busy guy because you're finishing up school at UNL. You are an MC, you're a motivational speaker, you're ranked as one of the top 30 beatboxers in the U.S. Wow. In fact, you did a statewide tour that the lead sent you out on. So you're a very busy guy. Why are you excited to be part of this project?
I'm excited to be a part of the project because as a entertainer, you don't usually get to find things and work on things directly that are important in your own community. You hear about something that's in someone else's community or an issue that affects the world globally, but this is happening in Lincoln. This is something that we can change, and this is a show about the change that is happening, the change that we are pushing for, and really this is going to be an eye-opener. So I'm so thankful to be a part of this, and I'm excited because it's going to change a lot of things here in Lincoln.
Barb, do you think most people in the community were surprised when Vital Signs came out with the story about childhood hunger?
Especially, you know, it's more than just hunger, too. I mean, as you said, there are a lot of pieces, and hunger is one of the pieces to poverty. The University Public Policy Center, Dr. Nancy Shanks, and I made a lot of presentations in the community. I have to tell you, that was always the big surprise. People just really struggle to be able to believe that that's true in our community. So I think the original 13 funders who wanted to put this together to help educate the community have been really pleased with how the community has embraced this, and really almost every time, I would say every time, the question is, what can we do to help?
Mm-hmm. Well, the Grumble Project has a huge mission to raise awareness about the realities of childhood hunger in the Lincoln community and to find the means and solutions to feed our future. Is that doable?
If we all get together, I think we can do it.
And this is an example of what can happen.
Absolutely. It's a great example of how so many different parts of the community are coming together. And we're so thrilled to be partnering with the Food Bank on this project. And one of the things I think that's unique about the show is that even though it's a challenging topic, Becky and David, the creators of the show, have done it in a fun show. It's mm-hmm. for all ages. The music ranges from tango and hip hop to traditional Broadway. It's a musical. Mm-hmm. And so it's really, while there's moments that make you want to cry, because it does hit some tough times with family and the kids, there's lots of laughter and lots of just fun characters. And so it's going to be great to hear the community reaction. And this will be the world premiere of a brand new musical.
Now, this wasn't two adults creating a musical all on their own. We do want to mention that to Becky Boson and David Von Kampen were inspired by the kids of the Clinton Creative Club. What is the Clinton Creative Club?
Well, one of the things that Becky does that I just love as a playwright is she researches the topics for the shows that she creates. And so she and Peter Walquist on our staff went to Clinton Elementary here in Lincoln and created the Clinton Creative Club, mm-hmm. where the kids just basically did creative activities from writing and drawing, and they shared their stories through creative activities. And then that basically being able to observe their everyday life and their thoughts and their cares and their happiness and their concerns, they were able to understand kids in a wide variety of challenging situations and be able to take some of those elements and apply them to the characters of the show. So basically the characters of the show are inspired from the real life stories of kids right here in Lincoln.
Okay, we want to tell about the details now. The world premiere of Puddin' in the Grumble is coming to Lincoln March 10th through the 20th at the Johnny Carson Theater at the Lead Center for Performing Arts. For tickets, you can call the Lead Center. That's 402-472-4747. LeadCenter.org is the website. And we also need to explain what this is. This is from the show. This is a character called Wuzzlebutt. It is a purple llama. Duane, tell us about this lovely little llama.
Wuzzlebutt is Puddin's best friend. Wuzzlebutt is seen putting through a lot of things, and Wuzzlebutt stays throughout the show as kind of a constant. It's, for me at least, every audience member, I will say about the show, every audience member is going to connect with it a little bit differently. And so as I see Wuzzlebutt, Wuzzlebutt is the constant reminder for me that this is a child. This is a child going through real things, and there are also real solutions, as well as some of the solutions accompanying the real ones being having a friend. Always there, someone that you know you can talk to no matter what's going on. And as the show develops, you see how this friendship then couples with other real friendships throughout the show to provide a very real solution to some of the problems that we see here in Lincoln.
Now, the audience who comes to see Puddin' in the Grumble will also get an opportunity to talk to some of the people who are involved in the production and involved as well in the problem of childhood hunger with talkbacks after some of the performances?
Absolutely. The Lead Center has a variety of shows every year where they address community issues or social issues, and so on this one, after the show, there'll be opportunity to ask questions about some of the things that are happening in Lincoln, how they can help, as well as if you're a person in that situation, how you can get help. And so it's a wonderful dialogue. It's amazing the information that's shared, and also it's a great resource. So we really do encourage people after they see the show to stay, because sometimes some of the most meaningful moments are those real life exchanges after the show.
And Barbara, where do you hope this goes? What do you hope is, this was sparked out of Vital Signs. What do you hope Puddin' in the Grumble leads to?
Well, I hope that it'll be a spark for more conversation in the community, more organizations to look at their strategies and plans and how can they help end poverty in our community and help more children be successful citizens of our community.
Okay. And we also want to mention that the Food Bank of Lincoln has started a website called grumbleproject.org, and there is something on the website called Grumble Stories. Mm-hmm. Bill, tell us about that aspect of the whole project.
One of the things that the Food Bank is doing is encouraging people to share their personal stories of moments when they had a food issue in their life. And it's amazing, so many people that you would never imagine at one time were hungry or facing poverty. So these are stories of that a variety of people in Lincoln will be sharing, and also has resources on how you can help and how you can make a difference and help Lincoln.
All right. So Puddin' in the Grumble, March 10th through the 20th, Johnny Carson Theater at the Lead Center. Again, 472-4747 or leadcenter.org for tickets. And you can check out the Food Bank's Grumble Project website, grumbleproject.org. Thank you all so much for being here, and we'll look forward to seeing you and your amazing voice on stage.
Thank you so much for having us.
As well as Wuzzlebutt. Up next, Bill Steffen will stay with us to talk about the rest of the Lead Center's exciting spring season. And as we go to break, enjoy a new song called Wait and See from the new musical Puddin' and the Grumble.
If a person's a reflection of stuff that they've been taught, if I looked in the mirror, I'd see the lessons I forgot. I stole the orange and I took the bite. Grumble, and why does she growl? I gotta lay low, 'cause she's on the prowl.
This city isn't what outsiders think. Lincoln has always had the reputation of being a sleepy Midwest city, but not the type of place people think about living, especially young people. We've just never really been the place people dream about. That's about to change. It's time to change perceptions. Exciting things are happening in our city. Big things. Our spirit has a renewed sense of energy, and there's enthusiasm in our collective voice. You can feel it in the streets, see it on the skyline, hear it in the ideas of our young entrepreneurs and creative class. This might be a quiet, laid-back city, but it's buzzing with a flourishing economy and a rich, vibrant culture. Be young. Have a booming career. Raise a family. You can do it all here. And it just keeps getting better. We're the crossroads of blue skies and bustling progress, the sweet spot of balanced living. If It feels good to be here, to be a part of it. In Lincoln, life is right. Now, it's time to let the world know.
Welcome back to Out and About. Bill Steffen joins us again, the Executive Director of the LEAD Center. And we want to talk a little bit about what's coming up this spring season. I know last year you celebrated your 25th anniversary. Everyone was going, what are they going to do to top that? And I think possibly you have.
Well, we love bringing the greatest artists in the world and every art form under the sun. And this spring, there's literally something at the LEAD Center almost every week. Ranging from Broadway to one of the greatest orchestras in the world, dance, theater, there's definitely something for everyone.
Well, Broadway is one of my favorites at the LEAD Center. Let's talk a little bit about Flashdance and Riverdance coming
sure.
up.
Sure. Well, I believe it's the premiere of the musical Flashdance for Lincoln, Nebraska. And so if you love the movie, you're going to love the musical. And it's all those hit songs from the 80s with lots of fun dancing, the same story, you know, of the wannabe performer in the steel mill and all that stuff. So it's going to be a fun show filled with lots of 80s hits.
And it was
and dancing, of course.
Yes.
And the water scene. They got the water scene happening.
And this really was a big hit on Broadway.
It was. People love it. It's a fun show. So.
I can't believe Riverdance is celebrating its 20th anniversary
already. Yeah, the anniversary of Riverdance, and it's a bigger and better show than ever. And we're thrilled to have it at the LEAD. We have three performances, including St. Patrick's Day.
Oh,
which you
great.
Gotta love that. If you don't have your tickets for St. Patrick's Day yet, there's very limited for that show, but we do have a good number of tickets available for the Tuesday and Wednesday performance.
The other Broadway show coming up this spring is Annie, coming up April 21st and 22nd. And we've got some popular music coming up, the Music of Styx.
Yes.
This is gonna be a lot of fun.
Yeah, I'm a huge Styx fan. Loved Styx music my whole life. And Dennis DeYoung is the original lead singer. He wrote most of the songs of Styx. He's the voice that you think
right,
of when
right.
you hear Styx. And so he'll be...
I'm hearing Lady in
exactly,
my head,
right? Yeah. So yeah, all those hit songs that he sang. And so, you know, he hasn't been singing with the Styx, the band, in a number of years. It's a little bit like Paul McCartney and John Lennon. And I would say he's the John Lennon. Paul McCartney of the group, and it's going to be great to hear all those hit songs performed with his voice and him playing piano, and he has his own band, and it will be an exceptional night of classic rock music.
Great. We've got a couple of dance productions coming up. April 2nd is Parsons Dance. April 19th, the Parsons Moscow Dance. Festival Ballet is going to do Romeo and Juliet. That should be really wonderful. Mm-hmm. Jazz and world music is another fun music genre that you carry at the LEAD Center. New Orleans Jazz Orchestra, March 11th,
Pablo Ziegler.
Pablo
yes.
Ziegler Quartet for New Tango,
yes.
March 31st. And then Doc Severinsen is coming, and he's going to be with the Nebraska Jazz Orchestra.
Yes, Nebraska Jazz Orchestra is celebrating their 30th anniversary, and we're thrilled to be having Doc Severinsen back. And of course, Doc Severinsen, the band leader for Johnny Carson's Tonight Show. And we're actually going to be having a free event in the Carson Theater prior to the concert, and you can watch the best of the Johnny Carson show, including Doc Severinsen. So if you want to come see some of those episodes that you haven't seen in a long time, including Johnny Comes Home, it's a great time to celebrate Johnny Carson's legacy and Doc Severinsen. Then you can come to the show and hear the Tonight Show theme and all those big band classics. Doc was here a few years ago. And amazing. He was out in front of the band the whole night, playing all the high notes, all those great melodies, and of course you got to come see the Jackets.
Well, and we've got such a good connection with Johnny Carson here in Nebraska.
Absolutely.
And at the university.
Absolutely,
so.
Yeah. We're so proud to be University of for Johnny Carson in terms of his being an alumni, and I'm so proud of him and his legacy. And Doc Severinsen, it's fun to reminisce with him and hear the stories and celebrate the music of Johnny Carson's Tonight Show.
Absolutely. Now tell me about Fela. This is going to be a Broadway musical in concert.
Yes. Fela was a really popular show on Broadway. Will Smith was one of the producers. The choreography is Bill T. Jones, you know, an amazing modern dance. And it's the story of Fela, who many people describe him as the James Brown of Africa. And it's an amazing show, cultural, exciting, lots of dancing. It's a cultural experience. The cast were either on Broadway or on the First National Tour. So this is top-notch talent and with all that music and the dancing. And it'll be an exceptional performance. I think it's the first time they've ever been in Nebraska. Probably the only time, to be honest. And so this is your one shot to experience this multicultural musical. And this also, we have a free showing of the documentary. There's a documentary called Finding Fella, and it will be shown at the Ross. And so you can kind of find out the whole story of his life as well as his music in advance of the show.
Now, the theater offerings this spring include Puddin' and the Grumble, which mm-hmm. we talked about, March 10th through the 20th. And the Actors Gang is going to present a performance called a play called The Exonerated. Mm-hmm, what mm-hmm. is that all about?
Well, Exonerated is a very hard-hitting play of the stories of I think it's six individuals who were wrongfully convicted. And it's their real-life stories taken right out of the history books and the documents from court records. And you're in the Carson Theater up close and personal, and you hear the actual life stories of these people who were wrongfully convicted and what happened to them, how it impacted their life. I don't think anyone who goes to that event will leave the same. And I think, you know, it's thought-provoking, and I think it's particularly, you know, as a nation, it's something that, you know, we're challenged mm-hmm. with. And so I think, again, you know, it's one of those things that art can communicate some things that sometimes politics, you can't sift through the reality. And this is a show that really shows the reality of people in America who were challenged by the justice system.
It's very timely.
Yes, yeah. Yeah, and we booked it before all of the things happened here in Nebraska, so it was remarkable timing.
Well, moving on to the classical genre, one of the world's top orchestras is coming at the end of February. Tell us about the Russian National Orchestra.
Yes, we're thrilled to have the Russian National Orchestra come to the Lead Center. They're one of the top 15 orchestras in the world, and they're performing an all-Russian program, so what better, program than an all-Russian music program by one of the top Russian orchestras. And Yuzha Wang is one of the most celebrated pianists. And so she'll be performing solo with the orchestra. And it will be a night to remember, very powerful, very exciting.
Garrick Olson is doing a piano concert also on April 6th. And then moving on to comedy, Who's Live Anyway? April 29th, that's sold out. So we're not going to talk a whole lot about that.
There might be, anytime we have a sold out show, usually there's a few tickets that open up at the very end. So if you really want to go, show up on the night of the event or watch our website. Sometimes we have seats get released. But yeah, we're excited about the stars of Whose Line Is It Anyway coming back to the lead.
And your Fam Fest coming up in April, that's also getting close to being
sold out. It is. A Daniel Tiger, hit PBS show, and we've got a Fam Fest show before it. Really affordable ticket prices and fun event. Limited tickets available, and just keep watching our website. Maybe show up on the night of the show, and we'll do our very best to get you in to see the program.
What a great variety. That must be a challenge for you every year with the offerings that are available, finding just the right mix.
It is. We're actually in the mix of creating next year's season right now. And it's a challenge, but it's also so fun to be able to program in so many different styles and to try to serve all the different tastes of the community, provide that cultural enrichment, and tackle some tough issues that the art can really address. It's really a wonderful place, the Lead Center, that can serve so many different people. We have over 150,000 people come to the Lead every year. And we actually just we were in the top 100 theaters in the world again from Pollstar
Wonderful.
Magazine. And so it's a great time to come to the Lead and hope to see everyone come for the wide variety of programs.
Yes, we welcome all the visitors from outside of Lincoln.
Absolutely.
To come to Lincoln and experience this real treasure in our community.
Yeah.
Bill, thanks to you and your staff for the great work.
Thank you.
We want to mention tickets available, 402-472-47. The website is leadcenter.org. Thank you again.
Thank you.
We'll tell you about a new production of Civil War Voices coming to Lincoln, as well as the many other events going on in the capital city when Out and About continues.
This city isn't what outsiders think. Lincoln has always had the reputation of being a sleepy Midwest city, but not the type of place people think about living, especially young people. We've just never really been the place people dream about. That's about to change. It's time to change perceptions. Exciting things are happening in our city, big things, Our spirit has a renewed sense of energy, and there's enthusiasm in our collective voice. You can feel it in the streets, see it on the skyline, hear it in the ideas of our young entrepreneurs and creative class. This might be a quiet, laid-back city, but it's buzzing with a flourishing economy and a rich, vibrant culture. Be young, have a booming career, raise a family. You can do it all here, and it just keeps getting better. We are the crossroads of blue skies and bustling progress, the sweet spot of balanced living. It feels good to be here, to be a part of it. In Lincoln, life is right. Now, it's time to let the world know.
Welcome back to Out and About. Jeff Mull joins us now from the Convention and Visitors Bureau. And Jeff, it's time to celebrate Abraham Lincoln's birthday again.
How old is he?
Well, he was born in 1809.
Okay.
So you can do the math.
Okay, I'll get back to you.
All right. We've got something a little different for the Abe Lincoln birthday celebration this year. We're bringing back Civil War Voices, a wonderful musical written by Jim Harris. It's got some beautiful songs that were arranged by, it's familiar tunes, arranged by a Kansas City composer.
Nice.
8 performances at the Haymarket Theater starting February 11th, and it's a great show. It was here, played at the Lead for one night only,
right.
Standing room only, standing ovation. So we're bringing it back, and it's kind of the newest version.
Yeah, this is good that this is a kind of a new adaptation, a new event for the city as far as the celebration goes. Free pre-show parties. Great chance to stick around afterwards with the playwright himself and talk about some questions and answers kind of
things. We're going to do that both Friday nights, and then we're having a pre-show party opening night, February 11th, so that'll be a lot of fun. We want to mention that our presenting sponsor is Cornhusker Bank, who's been a longtime supporter of the event. We've got support from the Nebraska Arts Council, Nebraska Cultural Endowment, many local businesses, organizations, and individuals, including the Convention and Visitors Bureau.
Right, and I'm asking this question now because I love cake. Well, we have birthday cake
this
year at
the celebration. We will have birthday cake.
Excellent. A nice marble
on
cake.
February 11th.
White. What are we going to do? What was
it's
Abe's favorite?
It's always spice. His was gingerbread, but the closest we can get is spice
cake. Okay, I like it. I'm putting it down right now.
All right. Now, if you want tickets, haymarkettheater.org is the website, or you can find a link on the city website. We've got a lot of information at lincoln.ne.gov. So don't miss Civil War Voices.
Sounds like a great idea.
It is. It's going to be a lot of fun. And we're going to talk more theater now at the Haymarket after Abe leaves. They're going to do Having the Time Machine.
That's right. The story of young Philby, the inventor, inviting some scientists to his home to hear about this latest invention. And I'll tell you what, a machine that travels through time is pretty amazing, even for that period. Should be a lot of fun. Look at H.G. Wells' classic at the Haymarket Theater.
All right. I think a time machine is only, it's about the time we get driverless cars.
Is that coming?
Yeah.
Would Dave Norris tell us, though, give us street updates, even though we would have driverless? Just kidding. Love you, Dave.
I'm a little worried about those. Community Playhouse has a fun camp for spring break. It's a week-long camp where the kids rehearse all week and perform on, I believe, a Saturday or Sunday. And it's got a kind of a tongue-twister name.
Yeah, the Journey of Noble Narble Spring Break Camp, and this obviously will take place on the ocean floor. That's what they're going to work on all week, this production that comes together that brings the rarest of creatures together, but none as rare as Narble himself.
Okay, sounds like fun, and find out what the Narble is. We also want to mention the Playhouse's biggest fundraiser of the year, the Lincoln Wine and Food Experience, is coming up at the end of February. Again, Russ's Market has raised $250,000 for the Playhouse since they started this.
That's pretty amazing. And the fact that we are able to do this every year and continue to raise money, a great partnership between Russ's and the Lincoln Community Playhouse. Come one, come all, because the wine and food that's served,
it's
you're not going to find it anywhere else.
No, it's amazing stuff. And don't eat beforehand.
Yeah, I know.
It's pretty good. Now, Nebraska Wesleyan is marking the 400th anniversary, 400th of William Shakespeare's death, with a spring series of shows written or inspired by the Bard, and one of those is Othello.
Othello. Love, race, jealousy, and betrayal intertwine into Shakespeare's most powerful tragedy. This is the first of a few things that we're going to talk about at Nebraska Wesleyan.
And Desdemona, I think we talked about this a little bit last week. It's another take on Othello, and it's kind of going on at the same time, so you kind of get two different looks at Othello at Nebraska Wesleyan.
Yeah, this should be a lot of fun and a great way to wrap up a great celebration, 400 years at Nebraska Wesleyan, or William Shakespeare's death, the celebration itself. So,
I think we should celebrate his birth, not his death.
I think we should.
Of course, it is 400 years,
yes.
So that's a big mark. Noel Coward's play is coming to the Howell Theater at UNL, and it's a sharp wit, exquisite style, a spirited comedy about ghosts.
Yeah, this should be a lot of fun over at the Howell Theater at UNL.
And Tada is having a stand-up comedy cabaret at the beginning of March. They've got some comics mm-hmm. that are seen on HBO and Showtime, and
yeah.
that should be fun.
Yeah, pretty amazing cast, and Tada continues to amaze. I mean, they have a full calendar year every year of great events, so this is a great way to start off the new year. Hard to believe we're in February already, by the way.
It is, and it's hard to believe that Bob Rook once earned a living as a stand-up comedian, so maybe he'll do some comedy that night, too.
It's still a fun guy to kind of go out with yes, and chat with, I'll tell you.
Yes, he is. We're going to talk about music next, mm-hmm. and the very familiar Bobby Lane Orchestra is having a Valentine's Dance.
Yeah, Valentine's Dance and Big Band Wednesday with performances by Bobby Lane and his orchestra. Bobby's been playing the Playmore for a long, long time. The Playmore is one of those places, if you've not set foot in there, probably start thinking about doing it because it's been around for so long. It's a masterpiece right
here
in Lincoln.
It is. It's a very special place. The Nebraska Brass has got a concert coming up, Midwinter Night's Dream.
Yeah, a great opportunity with the Nebraska Brass to escape the winter blues. The concert series features music by renowned composers Korsakoff, Schumann, Debussy, and Kurt Welly, and should be a lot of fun over there, and just some great Irish folk tunes and so forth.
That'll be a lot of fun. Now, there's a special concert coming up for Arts from the Soul that features the Celtic ensemble Solas, with the Boston Globe called it the finest Celtic ensemble this country has ever produced.
That's right. Solas' 20th anniversary project celebrates their remarkable past while demonstrating they are simply the best still now today. A lot of great history there as well. First Presbyterian Church will be the site for that.
Capitol Jazz Society has a couple of events coming up. Some of these are ongoing. There's the Monday Night Big Band.
Right. Great opportunity to bring your own instrument. You can get in for half price. So regardless of what instrument you have, you get a chance to play with the UNL Jazz Orchestra as well as Capitol Jazz Society. Great a venue at the Vega. If you haven't been down to the Vega, down in the rail yard, great music venue.
They're also doing a Friday Live at 5. Coming up starting in March.
That's right. It will feature local jazz groups playing some great live music. Swing by after work on a Friday for some great food and some great music. They do have really good food over at Vega, too. Mm-hmm. Who knew? It's a great little food venue as well.
And, of course, the rail yard's always fun.
It's always hopping.
Lincoln Civic Orchestra is doing a free concert with Nebraska Wesleyan Senior Soloists. That's coming up February 28th.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And then the Lincoln Choral Artists Winter Concert has a Gatsby theme.
Yes, and it has a new venue of sorts, something that we don't typically talk about for music or the arts. That is the Speedway Motors Museum of American Speed out on Sun Valley Lane. Great venue in itself, but to have some music in there as well should be a magical night.
Lincoln Organ Showcase is bringing another young organist into town. This one is a UNL alum.
That's right. He holds degrees from UNL and Notre Dame. Michael Emrich, completing work on his doctorate at the University of Kansas as well. He's an associate organist at the Co-Cathedral of Sacred Heart in Houston. This will be out at North American Martyrs Church in Northwest Lincoln.
Now, a special exhibit is opening in mid-February at the Robert Hillestad Textiles Gallery. And this is a very special little spot. They have wonderful things there. And this is going to be kind of a different type of exhibit with custom designed garments.
That's right, and this will take a look at some of Nebraska's most notable women and the garments that came along from that period of time, including Nebraska Governor Kay Orr, and that was done by Nebraska diner Marianne Vaccaro. Everything will be on display at the Textiles Gallery. Admission is free.
Okay, next page. My fingers aren't working today, must be too cold. Oh, we're gonna talk about basketball.
Tis the season.
Girls and boys state basketball. Wow, this. Can't believe it's that time already.
It is. We've kind of flown through January and February, and as a convention and visitors bureau, we get excited about the state high school boys and girls basketball championships. Things get going with the girls championship that first week of March. Second week of March is boys state basketball. Everything culminates down to Pinnacle Bank Arena. We'll be using the venues at Devaney as well as various state high schools. So this is the opportunity, regardless of what way people are going down a wrong way street, wave at them, tell them hi, help them out. And, you know, Lincoln just remains an amazing community to host these tournaments. And it is all about Lincoln residents coming out and supporting the athletes. We'll have visitor information tables at all the sites. We do the pizza feeds where every mm-hmm. high school athlete that competes comes back down to Pinnacle Bank Arena for the traditional pizza feed, and we enjoy being a part of that.
And it's up to everybody in town to make sure this is a great experience for our visitors.
That's right, and I will get a hold of Wendy over at the Chamber of Commerce and make sure we have Chamber of Commerce weather for those both weekends, because We typically have a snow event.
Yes, we
around
do.
Around there, so.
I think we've had our enough snow for the year.
I think we're good.
Well, let's talk a little bit about another cold event.
Right,
this is
right.
Probably the coldest event of the year. And Jeff, you'll be plunging into homes like this year, correct?
Calendar's pretty full around that time. This is the Polar Plunge for Special Olympics at Holmes Lake. I did have a chance to do this 3 years ago.
Really?
And, I can tell you your body slows down when you get into the water and you go to make the turn. Everything gets a little cold at that point. You get out, the cold water is off of you, but the cold air typically adds to the accelerated. It's bad.
Yes.
This is a great event to celebrate and support Special Olympics Nebraska. I encourage people to put together teams, come in costumes, raise money. I know the mayor's been a part of this
in the past. The mayor's done it before, yes.
This is a lot of fun. And it looks like they're going to have to cut a hole out in the ice this year where we've had water in the past to mm-hmm. just go into. So.
Well, it's a little chilly, but it really is fun to watch, too. If you're not the brave type who wants to do the plunge, it's a lot of fun to watch.
If it's a bucket list, this is the event to do it.
Another big fundraiser, the Team Jacket Gala, is coming up at the beginning of March at the Embassy Suites. And we've got a Hall of Famer here.
Yeah, that's right. Former Buffalo Bill Jim Kelly, who is a cancer survivor himself most recently, will be the keynote speaker at the event. There's a VIP reception, social hour, dinner. A lot of great celebrities will be there, local athletes, Husker athletes. So it's a great chance to get out and support the Team Jack Foundation.
And little Jack will be there as well.
Love
although
it.
He's probably getting pretty big.
I bet he is. He's about ready to probably try out for the Huskers before you know it.
He's already got that touchdown on the
He books. Does.
So let's move on to the Lancaster Event Center. We've got a turn and burn barrel race.
You like
Sounds like
that.
A rip-roaring time.
It does. It's going to be an action-packed night. Come out and watch some of the greatest barrel racing in the Midwest at the Lancaster Event Center.
And Winterfest and Antique Show, you never know what you might stumble across.
That's right. Dollar off tickets are available at most antique stores and the Lancaster Event Center's lobby. Also look for them in the Journal Star. Stop out to the Event Center for great antiques action.
Then you can take your dog to the Lancaster Event Center at the end of February. The I Love My Dog Expo. This would be a lot of fun.
Does this sound like a loud event to you? A lot of barking? But I'll tell you what, whether you're looking for something different to do with a dog, meet the veterinarians, learn about the products, learn about health and wellness, this is a great event to be at. Proceeds going to Domestipups.
Domestipups, and they provide therapy dogs and service dogs and adoptable dogs, and who doesn't love it? A nice, warm puppy.
Puppies are great.
Then they turn into great big dogs.
They do. But I'll tell you what, they're a great part to have in the family.
The Shrine Circus is going to be at the Event Center. And have they been at the Event Center before? It seems to me they've been there one other time.
Yep, they have. And they have a new venue now. This is the 71st Annual Shrine Circus. Come one, come all. It's a great benefit for the Shriners Hospital. A lot of great dollars go back to that event.
We want to talk a little bit about the VVS Leagues. This is something I was not familiar with, but VVS Leagues is an organization that has mm-hmm. darts, pool, foosball, and shuffleboard competitions. I looked them up.
Right.
And they've got three events coming up in the capital city, starting with a pool championship.
That's right. This is the capital city championships. Over 1,000 participants from Lincoln. All skill levels will be included in this event, and this will be at the Lancaster Event Center. Now, our friend Tom Lorenz has hosted these VVS events down at Pershing Center. So it's great that Marshall Coates at VVS has found a new venue, and I think the Event Center will do a great job.
All right, there's going to be a Dart League Lincoln City Championships coming up. I'm not sure if this location has been decided yet, but it is coming up at the beginning of March.
Yeah, 400 participants from around Lincoln as well. Pool and darts, I mean, those are great bar activities that are very competitive. So come out to be a spectator. It's free, so come out and enjoy it.
And speaking of a bar activity, everybody's favorite, foosball, is coming to the Garage Sports Bar and Grill. It's the 13th annual Foosmania.
Yeah, a lot of people don't realize you and I have a foosball table right out back here, and we're going to be practicing.
I wish. I'm terrible at it. I've never been able to play that.
It's a lot of work.
It is.
It is a lot of work. My kids do very well against me on that. Over 125 participants, all skill levels. Again, it's as much of a mental game as it is a physical
one.
So I think the mental side is where I fall down on that.
I fall down on both.
Do you?
Yeah.
Just not working hand-eye coordination.
No.
Great opportunity. And VVS, again, VVSleagues.com is the website. I'm glad you did some research on it because a lot of people know the vending side of VVS, vending. Same organization, great Lincoln company. Again, thank you to Marshall Coates for what he does with this event.
And it's VVSleagues.com. That's where you find out about all the ways you can participate in darts, pool, foosball, and shuffleboard.
Ah, it sounds like a lot of fun.
It does. It does. And it's a great time to live in Lincoln. That's
it is.
For sure.
It is. I actually just left the University of Nebraska today talking to their hospitality students and getting them excited about Lincoln, and just to see a lot of these freshmen and sophomores' eyes that a lot of them in the past couldn't wait after 4 years to leave Lincoln. Mm-hmm. After we talk about everything going on in Lincoln, just it's a great time to be here. They're excited about being a part of the community going forward. So we hope everybody does that.
And that's a good age for concert goers. We're going to be talking about what's coming up at Pinnacle Bank Arena in Pinewood Bowl when Out and About continues with Tom Lorenz. But first, we want to give the website. Lincoln.org.
That's right. You can call us down for our visitor center at 7th and P, and that number is 434-5348.
All right. Thank you very much, Jeff, and we'll be right back.
This city isn't what outsiders think. Lincoln has always had the reputation of being a sleepy Midwest city, but not the type of place people think about living, especially young people. We've just never really been the place people dream about. That's about to change. It's time to change perceptions. Exciting things are happening in our city, big things. Our spirit has a renewed sense of energy, and there's enthusiasm in our collective voice. You can feel it in the streets, see it on the skyline, hear it in the ideas of our young entrepreneurs and creative class. This might be a quiet, laid-back city, but it's buzzing with a flourishing economy and a rich, vibrant culture. Be young, have a booming career, raise a family. You can do it all here, and it just keeps getting better. We are the crossroads of blue skies and bustling progress, the sweet spot of balanced living. It feels good to be here, to be a part of it. In Lincoln, life is right. Now, it's time to let the world know.
Don't miss Civil War Voices, the real words, the real music, the real heart of a country divided. The city's Abraham Lincoln Celebration, Cornhusker Bank, and the Nebraska Arts Council will present 8 performances of this award-winning musical by Lincoln playwright Jim Harris. It's on stage at the Haymarket Theater February 11th through the 21st. For more information and tickets, visit haymarkettheater.org or lincoln.ne.gov.
And welcome back to Out and About. Tom Lorenz joins us now to tell us all the latest from Pinnacle Bank Arena and Pinewood Bowl. And we're going to start with Pinewood Bowl because the season's shaping up pretty nicely and we've got the other Beatle coming.
We do. We've got Ringo coming out. You know, we had so much fun with Paul. It was great to have Ringo to be able to come out to Pinewood Bowl. Terrific opportunity. Ringo and his all-star band, Todd Rundgren, Greg Raleigh, a bunch of other great players. It will be a tremendous season out at Pinewood Bowl. And Ringo's going to be one of our stars out there.
That's great. I wish the other two Beatles were around that they could come
too.
To Lincoln too.
I do too.
But having Paul and Ringo here is great.
Yep.
21 Pilots show coming up July 28th. I understand that's sold out.
It is sold out. They're one of the hottest bands out there right now, and people snatch those tickets up very quickly. That's a general admission show. We'll have about 5,500 people, and it will be an outstanding show, a great way to kind of end July and kick us into all the cool stuff that'll happen in August.
Now, some legendary bands, Beach Boys and Temptations, will be here August 11th. That one sold out, too.
That one went up on sale, and people couldn't get them fast enough. So that'll be a great day. You know, we got a couple of the original Beach Boys. We've got some original Temptations. It's just fun music, and nothing better for a hot summer night than sitting out and listening to some really, really awesome classic rock.
Walk the Moon is also coming up August 12th, and I don't know much about this band. Tom, tell me about them.
Their tour is called Work This Body. They're a new band out there. They've spent a lot of time on top of Billboard's, hot new band type of a survey. The big song they have out there is Shut Up and Dance, and a lot of people recognize that. At Pinewood Bowl, we try to have a really wide variety of bands. This one will really appeal to millennials, younger people, and it's just great music. They're going to have a tremendous time out there. After 21 Pilots, this will be a nice second piece to get that kind of demographic. So that goes on sale very soon after we record this, and we think that'll be a show that'll sell very well also.
Well, we're taping this early February, first mm-hmm. week of February. There's 4 shows announced so far. How many more will there be for
Pinewood
Bowl?
We will get to at least 10 and maybe beyond that. So there's quite a bit more to come.
The biggest
this
yet.
Will be the best season ever, and it's a nice wide variety of things, and we can't wait. This will be a fun summer.
We've got a couple of new shows announced for Pinnacle Bank Arena. Two country shows coming up.
Yeah, Alan Jackson's going to come out. He's been a hit maker for 25 years. He has a tremendous amount of number one songs, always puts on a terrific show. He just wrote some brand new music, and the album is doing very, very well. So he's extending his tour out. We'll get him November 4th. It will be, a really nice night. Alan Jackson is, kind of country royalty, so it'll be great to have him in. And then Keith Urban is coming out October 8th. Played at the State Fair, did a tremendously, a big crowd out at the State Fair. To be able to get him in, he's kind of doing his tour two different ways. He's doing a summer tour where it's the amphitheaters. Then he takes a month off and retools the whole show to go into arenas, and he'll do a whole arena tour. And we're very, very happy to have him come in. He starts in North Dakota, comes to Lincoln, and then it's all major cities from there on out. So, again, Pinnacle Bank Arena and the fans here in Lincoln and Southeast Nebraska continue to buy those tickets. That gets us those big shows, and we're really, really thankful for all the support we get.
Well, let's talk about some of the shows that were announced already, starting with Blake Shelton. He'll be here February 25th, and that one is, tickets are all gone.
They're gone, and Blake, with his exposure on The Voice and just all the great songs he writes, that'll be a very, very good show. Look forward to having him. We really are getting all of the big country shows, and if we haven't got them yet, they may be scheduled for the future here soon, so keep watching those kind of things.
All right, we've got Life in Color then the night after Blake Shelton.
That's right.
This is the world's largest paint party.
It is, and it's great EDM music. Aoki is the DJ that night, world famous, tremendous music. The paint part's kind of an interesting part, but it does make it fun, and the kids really like it. We'll be able to do about 6,000 folks there that night on the floor of the Pinnacle Bank Arena and throughout. And I'm glad we're doing it, Blake first and then Life in Color. It makes the cleanup overnight a little bit easier.
You'll have a little bit of time in between Life in Color and Lil Wayne then on March 6th.
That's right. Lil Wayne, is putting out new music all the time. Classic as far as urban music and rap, a tremendous artist in his own. So it'll be a great night. Terrific opener that night, March 6th, right between Boys and Girls State Basketball. So it's a fun time, lots of students in town, and there's still tickets available for that. So I think we'll have a very nice crowd that evening.
Carrie Underwood then is coming up a little later in March, and there's just a few tickets left for this one.
There's just a few, and Carrie continues to be, in the media all the time. She's really come out. Her last album, the album she wrote and did some other songs with it, has been very, very successful. She is a tremendous artist, and she really hasn't toured that much lately, so we're very happy to have her come in. It's one of those shows that came because we had some other successes with Shania and Bieber and all the other ones. They're kind of all the same promoter, and so that'll be a very, very nice show, good family show, a great night for people to come out.
All right, April, you've got three big family draws all in a row, starting with Harlem Globetrotters, then Monster Jam, then Sesame Street Live. It'll be a great month to get the kids out.
It's a nice time. It's kind of late towards the school year. Kids are getting a little restless. It's time to kind of get out from being stuck inside all winter long. So all of those shows are terrific. The Globetrotters put on a great show. Monster Jam is just so much fun. I mean, when we have the dirt inside, the best monster trucks out there, it's amazing. It's not just a family thing. A lot of college kids come out. A lot of couples come out. It's just a fun evening, and there's always a lot of excitement with that.
And a lot of noise.
And a lot of noise, And then Sesame Street, has been a classic here in Lincoln for years and years. Still put on a wonderful show. It's a great exposure time for the first time to bring a kid out to see a show like that. Families enjoy it together. We grew up with Sesame Street, and so it's fun to see that come in. And again, these are all well supported, and so we appreciate people coming out and seeing them.
And the big country act will wrap up April.
Brantley Gilbert, when he comes in, the kind of the start of a rock and roll country. I mean, he plays it hard, and he's one of the ball cap guys. It's a tremendous show. That one will be kind of a half house setting, and we can't wait for Brantley to come in. He played at Pershing some years back, did a terrific show, and nice to have him back, kind of that next level up here in Lincoln.
Of course, Alan Jackson was back at Pershing.
Alan was too. Yeah, I still remember we got our picture taken with Alan that day, and what a nice guy, and again, you know, I know it was a sellout at Pershing, and we expect a very big crowd at Pinnacle.
And you haven't changed a bit since 1995.
No, I look just the same, except for a little gray. But it's okay. We won't look at that.
All right. The Dirt is coming in May for the PRCA Championship Rodeo.
You know, we continue to work with a really great producer out of North Dakota who brings in the top stock. And so, I mean, when you have a rodeo, it takes two pieces. It takes tremendous stock, great bucking bulls, you know, great saddle bronc and everything else, and then to have the great cowboys to go with it. So I already had the stock. We've raised the prize money for the cowboys. We had a really good crop of terrific cowboys and cowgirls last year. With Pinnacle Bank Arena, we've got a much longer run for them. So the barrel racing's better, and you know, we've got instant replay and all the cool lighting. It's a great time, and I hope people are able to come out and enjoy some of this terrific rodeo.
Now, the Ringling Brothers and Barnum & Bailey Circus is coming. It's kind of the big circus. And I've seen some pictures from Lincoln in the past. Mm-hmm. When the circus came to town, they had a parade down O Street.
They used to do it two ways. They were, you know, back in the last time I was here, which was a long time ago, they would come in by train. And, you know, they'd park the train at a siding and unload it, and they'd have the big parade through mm-hmm. town. Now it comes in trucks. It's not quite the same spectacle downtown, but it's still the same great array of talent. Animal acts, high wire acts, all the different kinds of things. You know, no one does it better than Ringling Brothers and Barnum & Bailey. It's a spectacle, and it's a great family entertainment, great night out.
Justin Bieber is coming June 21st. How's that one selling?
Justin Bieber is just about sold out.
Is it?
He is, you know, one of the hottest acts out there right now, and I would say a top five kind of a, you know, an act. It is just amazing. He's kind of redone his image again. Not quite so much controversy, but he's still out there. And the music is very good. So he's drawing that a critical acclaim. Really fun to have him come into town, and it's just another kind of genre that we really haven't hit before.
The Cirque du Soleil, a different kind of circus, coming end of July.
Beautiful, Taruk, and it's based off of Avatar, and it will be a tremendously beautiful show. We've seen some of the pictures from it already. It's doing very well across the country. Cirque puts out just wonderful tours. They'll do maybe four or five different ones at the time. This is the best one that they have out right now. And it's a spectacle. It's not, you know, a circus where you've got clowns running around, but you've got people that are doing high wire, all the different effects. This will probably be one of our biggest production shows that we do. So I hope people come out and enjoy the spectacle of that.
Mm-hmm. The Belong Tour then is coming at the end of August.
You know, it's a great weekend for women to come out, moms, daughters, to spend some time together. It is a Christian-based an event, tremendous speakers that will speak to their hearts, and you'll spend some time on Friday night, come back on all day Saturday. A wonderful opportunity that used to be called Women of Faith. Belong is kind of their new direction with it. And we had over 11,000 women there on Saturday last year. We think it'll draw that much again, and they come from multiple states. It's just a nice time to come together and learn and spend time together and worship.
Now, Maroon 5 is returning to Lincoln in October. They played at Pershing as well.
They did. You know, when they played at Pershing, when they were first out, that was one of the smallest shows they played. But, you know, we have that little hook with having James Depp Valentine grow up here. And it was great to see James kind of plugging for us to get the show here also. But Maroon 5 will come in more popular than ever. Tremendous to have them in. That will be, you know, one of our best pop shows that we ever mm-hmm. do. So that's way out in October. There's a few tickets left. So if you want to go, look for those very quickly.
Now, we talked to Jeff about the Boys and State Girls Basketball Championships, and hopefully said there'll be some new people coming to Pinnacle Bank Arena, some people who haven't been there before.
It's always nice to have people from all across the state come in. And, you know, as the teams turn over and we get some new high school teams that make the tournament, it's fun to see the families come in and look at it for the first time. We want them to come into town, spend some time in the rail yard, spend some time in Haymarket, all throughout town, and then have a great time cheering their teams on. And the folks that have come the last few years love the rail yard and love mm-hmm. the area. Lots of parking, so it's, you know, we really get to become a showcase. And the kids get to play where the Huskers play, which is a lot of fun, too.
That's always a lot of fun. All right, thank you very much, Tom.
Thanks,
Diane. Keep up the great work. Again, for more information, PinnacleBankArena.com. are the websites. Tom, thank you.
Thanks.
We'll talk to you next month.
It's busy, and we'll keep it going.
All right. That is all for this month's Out and About show. I want to thank all the guests we had today. Now, if you missed any of the events, stay tuned. We'll be running a list again right after the show. Thank you for joining us, and we hope to see you out and about.